Welcome back to How to Create a Membership Site with Zero Coding. This is part number 5, how to set up WordPress for your membership site. Now, WordPress is the software that we will build your website on. It's your website structure. It's going to provide us with a great backend so we can add content to our site, so we can manage our members and make sure we lock down things so only our members can see it. So it's a really great system. There's about a third of the internet runs on WordPress. So it's super popular. It's pretty easy to use. So I'm going to show you how to install it in this video. This is part of stage 1 of creating our membership site, and that's creating the website itself. If you already have a website that runs on WordPress, then skip forward to part number 6 on how to set up wishlist member for your membership site. This is the membership plugin that I recommend. I'll show you how to go through all the settings and turn your WordPress site into a membership site. But if you don't yet have WordPress set up, then continue watching. First, we need to work out where your membership site will go. What do you mean, Ryan? My membership site's just gonna go on my domain, www.mymembershipsite.com or wherever it may be. But you actually need to think about choosing whether you're going to have a combined installation versus a separate installation. Now, let me explain what I mean by that. A combined installation is where your forward-facing website to people who aren't members is actually on the same WordPress installation as your membership site. So all of your free content needs to happen on the same installation as your membership site. And this, while it gives you, I guess, kind of consistency of branding and can make things easier, it's actually a lot harder to do, especially if you're not a developer yourself. So I don't recommend a combined installation where you have your free content and marketing on the same installation as your membership site, because it just gets too complicated. The easier thing to do is to have a separate installation. And so this is, you have one WordPress website for all your marketing, all your sales pages, all your free content. And then what you do is you have a separate installation for your membership site. Now, there's a few ways to have these separate installations. You can have a subdomain. So this is my.melee.co. This is my favorite way to do it. You could have a URL extension. So melee.co/members would be an example of that. We'd have a separate WordPress installation on members, and unique domain is you would buy a separate domain like meleemembers.co and you would install it over there. I recommend the subdomain. A good example of this is a site called Lead Pages, which we'll talk about in a future episode on creating a sales page. But they have leadpages.net, and they've got a whole bunch of things on here like features and pricing. If we go to pricing, we can see it's leadpages.net/pricing. If we go to features, leadpages.net/features. So all their marketing sort of stuff is just on leadpages.net. However, if we click the login button, what you'll notice is they actually have a subdomain, my.leadpages.net. And so if I go ahead and log in, then you'll see that all of the back end of this membership site, which is actually a software tool, is actually based on a subdomain, my.leadpages.net. So we're going to take what Lead Pages have done in terms of their subdomain, and that's what I'm going to recommend, and that's what I'm going to show you how to do. Now, if you missed it in the previous video, I actually recommend Arvix as my web host, and that's who we'll be doing this tutorial with. If you want to sign up for Arvix, it's really cheap. It starts from $3.20 per month. Go to pelt.co/hosting, and if you use the code PELT discount, then that's how you can get the 20% discount off your initial invoice. So step number 1 is to log into your hosting cPanel. Now, cPanel stands for control panel. This is the back end of your hosting account, and we need to get access to this. So go back to that email that you originally got from Arvix that looks something like this, and we need to find this control panel information. Now, we can click on the first address if our name servers have changed, but what I prefer is the alternate address because this just works all the time. So let's go ahead and click on the alternate address. go ahead and log in using the username and password you chose when you signed up. So after we've logged in, we'll be brought to this page that should look something like this. This is your cPanel or control panel. We now need to create a subdomain. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to scroll down and we're going to look for the domain section and click on subdomains. We now just need to add our subdomain. So let me just make sure I've got the correct domain name. So in this case, it's melee.co. Common subdomains are my, so my.melee.co, or maybe members.melee.co, or maybe I was gonna call it melee plus, and so it could be plus.members.co. So you just choose whatever you want, it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna do my.melee.co and go ahead and click create. So our subdomain has now been created. Let's click on the home button to go back to this page here. And step number three is to open the Softaculous apps installer. So what we're doing on our cPanel homepage, we scroll down, it's right near the bottom. We can see Softaculous apps installer and we want to click on WordPress. That will then load up this page, and step number four is to click install, which is the blue button right here. So we'll go ahead and click install. We then need to fill out our settings. So I'm going to go through and show you exactly how to fill these out. So follow along, and if you need to pause it or you need to rewind and go back and follow this a couple of times, then go ahead and do that. So for the choose protocol, we're going to leave that. We need to choose our domain. So in this case, I'm actually choosing the my.melee.co. Where it says in directory, we actually want that to be completely empty so that it installs directly on my.melee.co. Remember how we're talking about the different installations? If you wanted to do a URL extension, for example, melee.co/members, what you would do is you would choose your domain, and where it says in directory, you would go ahead and write members, or you'll go ahead and write wherever you want that extension to be. So that's how you do that. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave it on the subdomain. Where it says table prefix, we're going to leave that. Site name and site description, we can change at a later date. So I'm just going to quickly write melee members, learn Super Smash Brothers Melee, okay? It doesn't really matter what you do. For the admin username and admin password, make sure you change the username from admin to something else. So I'm gonna put Ryan McLean, which is my name, and then create a password, example. Admin email, just change that to the main email that you use. Select language, we leave that as English. Limit login attempts, we ignore that. Under the advanced options section, we're going to want to expand that. And where it says database name, we're going to want to change that to something we'll recognize. So for me, I'm going to put my melee. Okay, so then I know that this is the installation for my melee. This will be important if you ever want to move your website to another host. Maybe you get super popular, so you need more expensive hosting. Just have the database name so you know what it is. I'm not going to bother with any of the other advanced options. I'm not going to select any themes. I'm now going to move on to step number six, which is just to install it. So let's go ahead and click the install button. And this will now go ahead and install WordPress for us. Once it's complete, you'll get this notification. Congratulations, the software was installed successfully. And we now need to go ahead and test whether our website is live or not. Now remember, it can take up to 48 hours to become live from when we change those name servers. So we can go and test it. We'll just click on this link that tells us where our website is. And I can see that my website is live, Melee Members Learn SSBM. It doesn't look amazing at the moment, but don't worry, I'll show you how to make changes to it so it can look the way you want it in a future tutorial. We can also test our login. So if we go to this administrative URL, we can go ahead and log in using the details we selected during the installation. So we're now logged in and everything seems to be working fine. Also, if you're having any issues and you're using Arvix like I am, you can always ask them for help. Just go to arvix.com and you click on this live support online button and you can go ahead and start a chat with them. I don't know how long this actually takes for them to get to you, so it might want to be something that you move to the side while you're doing something else in case it does take time to get support. Okay, for me, it only took less than a minute for them to connect. I'm not going to promise that to you. I'm not sure if I just got lucky, but I can go ahead and I can chat with Arun Kumar P and ask him my questions. I actually had a problem loading the plugins page inside WordPress, which is going to be important in the next step to add our membership plugin. And so for some reason it wasn't loading, so I just got in contact with them and then they just fixed the issue for me. Some issue with PHP, I have no idea what that means. So if you have any issues like I did loading the plugins page or loading any other page, just get in contact with them, let them know you're having a problem and they should be able to fix it for you. And that completes part 5, how to set up WordPress for your membership site. We now have a website that people can go to and view. Obviously, it needs some work, but hey, we're getting there. We've got the structure set up now. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to set up Wishlist Member for your membership site so that you can add controls on the content that you create and so you can make things that are just for members only, set it up so members can join and all of that sort of good stuff. So that's in the next lesson, so go ahead and watch that now. If you have any questions or need any help, or if you just want to view all of the course material, you can do that. Go to pelt.co/MS for membership site, and we've got a comment section there where you can ask questions if you get stuck on anything. And as well, if you're having trouble and you want us to do it for you, or you just don't have the time to go through and do this yourself, you can hire us. Go to pelt.co/services to see what services we offer.